I'm a crazy weirdo and I'm calling you. I've really got nothing better to do. I dial up your number and I let the phone ring. Then 2 minutes later I'll be doing it again. You might think that I'd move it along, but you would be wrong. I've got no life at all, and so I'll continue to call. I'm a crazy weirdo and I'm calling you.
Broadcasting from the PLA Situation Room in Roy, New Mexico, you're listening to The Snowplow Show.
Now it's time.
Cactus.
I'll make you think, stupid.
Cactus.
You've got to be crapping my balls.
Cactus.
I think this call is a hoe.
Cactus.
You're calling me a hobo.
Cactus.
Roy, the retarded boy.
Cactus.
How about if I come down and punch your head off?
Cactus.
You're blowing smoke up my ass.
Cactus.
Get out this fucking phone. Leave me alone.
Hello, everybody. This is RBCP, and you're listening to the Snowplow Show for May 12th, 2016. And today's special Civil War episode of the Snowplow Show is sponsored by Default Cecil. Thank you, Default Cecil, for sponsoring the show forever now. Earlier today, I did a live show on the YouTubes and on the Shoutcast, and it was pretty fun, even though I ran into a little bit of conflict around the middle of it, but I don't seem to have any announcements or anything to go over, so I guess we'll just get right into that. You're going to hear a little bit of Inception here, because in the beginning of the live show, I played a bunch of pre-recorded stuff that I recorded yesterday, and I don't know why I'm explaining all of this. I explained it all in the show. So I'm going to shut up and play today's live show after a brief word from our sponsors.
Confessions.
Eavesdrop on real people telling their innermost secrets.
I'm afraid my husband will find out. I'm leading a double life.
Darkest desire.
The safe was left unlocked today.
Most bizarre encounter.
I saw this woman today. I couldn't help myself.
Intimate secrets. 1-900-740-3040. $2 per minute. Secrets that have to be told. 1-900-740-3040 now.
Hello, everyone. This is RBCP. I'm getting ready to play I'm getting ready to play pre-recorded stuff. So yesterday I tried to put out a show yesterday. Wow, music's loud. And it wouldn't work. I just didn't get enough done. So I didn't finish the show yesterday. But anyway, I did a few calls, and those are going to lead into what I'm doing today. And I already recorded like an intro and everything, so that's all on here. So I'm just going to play this. It's about 17 or 18 minutes long. And as soon as this is over, we're going to get started with the live show. So I know you all tuned in to hear pre-recorded calls. So here it goes. Hope you enjoy these. Today I have a list of phone numbers, about 120-something phone numbers of school teachers. And the guy who sent it, he wishes to remain anonymous. He says, this is a list of names and phone numbers of people who called a school district's human resources department recently. And the list is an Excel file, my favorite. It has the date, it has the caller's name, it has the caller's position, the caller's location, the caller's email address, their phone number, their reason for calling, and whether or not it was resolved. Oh, and if it's resolved, it tells you who resolved it. So it looks like somebody that answers the phone all day at the school district, they just type a quick summary of what the person called about, and it's in this Excel file, I guess. So I've changed my caller ID to a school district phone number, and I'm going to give some of these people a call. The first lady, her name is Conquesta. She's a nurse, and she says she has a question about CPR certification found on website. Let's see what Conquesta needs.
Hello.
Hello, Conquesta?
Yes, it's she.
Hey there, it's Roy from the school district.
Mm-hmm.
And I see that you called in here and they're saying you don't know how to do CPR?
No. I was wondering if I had to redo my certificate.
Oh, no, ma'am. You need to know CPR. You have to know how to do CPR to be a nurse.
Yeah, I know that.
Come on.
Huh?
What kind of nurse are you if you don't know CPR?
What are you talking about?
I can't believe you're a nurse at a school and you don't even know CPR.
I'm not a nurse. And who's this again?
Well, it says here on this form that you're a nurse. What are you then?
What form are you looking at?
It's just our call logs that showed that you called in last week. I was just following up. Or I guess that was 2 weeks ago.
Yeah, it was 2 weeks ago. I'm not a nurse. I was calling to see if my CPR certification was due. I already have it.
Well, how come you don't know how to do CPR then?
That's not the question. Okay.
Well, I guess she's ashamed because she doesn't know CPR.
Hello?
Hey, Conquesta, we got disconnected somehow.
I hung up because you weren't saying the right things.
What? You hung up just because you're mad that you don't know how to do CPR? Come on, that's
you
not...
You have the incorrect information. Can I ask, what's your name?
You're not being very mature.
What's your name?
My name is Roy.
Roy what?
No, Roy who? I'm a person.
Roy who?
Correct.
Roy who?
Yeah, H-U, who.
Roy who?
Yes, correct.
What's your last name?
H-U, it's foreign. Stop being a racist.
Where are you from?
I'm from the school district. I'm just returning your call about you not knowing how to do CPR. That's all. It's not a big deal.
I never said I didn't know how to do CPR. Where'd you get my number from?
Well, I'm here at the school district, and it's on this list, and I'm just returning your call. I'm just, you know, this is what I do
Can you take my name off the list, please?
Well, why? Why'd you call in if you didn't want your name on the list?
Can you take my name off the list, please?
Are you just afraid people are going to know you don't know how to do CPR?
I know how to do CPR. What I called for was about recertifying.
Oh, well, you should know how to do CPR. You know, you're a nurse.
I'm not a nurse, again.
This list says you're a nurse, and the list doesn't lie.
You have the incorrect information.
Okay, well, you don't need to get all snippy with me. I'm just trying to help.
That's perfectly fine. What's your last name?
Oh, come on. This again?
Yes.
I already told you. Or, I mean, you guessed
it. Okay, well, can you stop calling me, please?
Okay, yeah, I won't call again. I was just trying to resolve your issue. And apparently, I don't know, you're okay with not knowing how to do CPR. Okay, she's gone. I swear it says on here that she's a nurse. So apparently the person manning the phones at the school district just suck at their job or something. Here's a lady who's a classroom assistant. Her name is Antoinette, and she says, calling in regards to seniority needs to be updated. Gave the email to Beth, and then Beth's last name. What does that mean, calling in regards to seniority? She just want to be higher on the chain so she can yell at people or something? I don't know.
Hello?
Hi there, this is Roy from the Roy Co. Private Investigator Services.
Hold on, Missy.
What? Okay.
I'm calling from the Private Investigator.
Hello?
Hey, I'm calling from the Private Investigator. This is Roy, and I just needed
Private Investigator?
Yeah.
Who do you want to speak to?
I was calling for Beth. I just needed to let you know we've put the GPS tracker on Antoinette's car, so you can go ahead and start tracking her whereabouts. Immediately, it's
Andrew, why y'all putting a GPS on Antoinette's car for? Her car is paid for.
What? Oh, no. This is just a general private investigation thing.
Why y'all putting a GPS on my car? I'm Antoinette.
Oh my gosh! You're Antoinette.
Yeah, right. This must be a scam. Yeah, I'm Antoinette.
It's just
a fucking scam. No, stop, Beth, to kiss my ass.
No. I'm sorry. I thought you were. I thought. Shit. Holy shit, that lady's a teacher? She must be picking up some bad language at the high school.
Hello?
Hi, I'm sorry, I was trying to call Beth.
This not bull. You call an Antoinette phone you want to put a GPS on for, so how much I gotta cost me to get the GPS on my car?
Ma'am, no, I accidentally called you. I was trying to call Beth.
No, Beth. This is Antoinette Carr. She want to put a GPS on a private investigator. You know what? Just a wake-up call for me, sweetie. Thank you.
What? No,
but I'm
no.
I'm not Beth. Tell Beth to kiss my ass.
Well, no, she... why would you... Holy shit. I am the worst private investigator ever. Let me try just one more time.
All right, you know what? Let me pull it over to the side, and we're going to get this straight, because I'm not Beth.
I know. It was an accident. I didn't mean to call you. I meant to call Beth and tell her.
So you just... Okay, you... So Antoinette... I'm Antoinette...
Okay, yeah,
You want... Yeah, so tell Beth you fucked up. Because you told her you want to put a GPS on my car.
Can you not...
My car is paid for.
No, I know. It's not
If you want to know my whereabouts, tell her to come to my house.
Hey, listen...
Who the fuck is Beth...
I'm trying to tell you. Why don't you just shut the fuck up? No, I'm just,
I will shut the fuck up. You call in my car, tell me I put a fucking GPS on my phone. It's probably a fucking scam. So go ahead, pussy. Tell me what you want me. You don't know. Call Beth. And again, kiss my motherfucking ass.
Okay.
And don't call my fucking
Antoinette, phone. I need to tell you something. Oh, my God. One last time. I really didn't want to tell her. I was just kidding.
Hello?
Oh my God! Listen, I'm calling from the school district. I don't know why you're yelling.
Okay.
Is this Antoinette still?
Is it what?
Is this Antoinette?
What's this call about, sir?
I'm calling from the school district here in. She's saying she's calling in regards to seniority, and I'm just returning her call because she needs to update some stuff.
She left.
She what?
She left.
She left. Where'd she go? I thought she was driving.
She went to the store.
Oh, okay. What's she getting? She getting a beer so she can calm her ass down?
Yes.
I mean, holy shit. She's a classroom assistant with us. I was just trying to tell her something.
Okay. I'll give her a message.
Okay. Tell her she's fired.
She's fired.
Yeah. Yeah, say, Antoinette, the school district called, and you're fired. And I was just kidding about that private investigator stuff. I was just trying to lighten the mood before I fired her.
Before you fire her?
Yeah, I was just trying to lighten the mood. I was just trying to put a little bit of humor in there, you know? So she wouldn't feel
Why is she fired?
For cursing too much on the phone.
Okay, thank you.
I mean, we can't have someone that talks like that around kids. You know?
Okay.
Hey, oh, hey, your phone's ringing. Who is it? Is it Antoinette?
No, this is not Antoinette.
Oh, balls. No, I'm just kidding. She's not fired. But you should tell her that just to hear her explode. Can you stay on the phone with me till she gets back and tell her she's fired?
No, thank you. I wouldn't want to say that to her.
Oh, come on. It'll be funny. She'll laugh. In the end, she'll laugh.
I'll tell her.
All right, tell her.
Okay, and what is this call really regarding?
You know, I was just bored. She called in here. She called the human resources department about her seniority because she thinks she's got like a big head or something. She thinks she needs seniority over everyone else.
She what?
She's got like a big head or something. She thinks she needs seniority over everyone else. I think that's what this means.
All right, I'll give it a message.
All right, tell her to stop having such a big head.
Okay.
And okay, all right. Well, thank you very much. Answer your damn phone.
Huh?
Answer your damn phone.
Oh, why are you cussing at me?
No, I'm not cussing at you. I'm just saying, answer your damn phone.
Look.
And also,
you work for the school district, right? Huh?
Yeah, I'm in the human resources department at the school district.
Yes.
And I'm telling you to answer your damn phone.
All right, thank you, sir. That's I wasn't cussing at you, so you really don't have the right to talk to me like that.
Well, you know, I'm just upset because of the way Antoinette talked to me, so it's her fault. You shouldn't.
Okay, but I'm not Antoinette.
But you shouldn't hang around people that talk like that to people. That's why you should tell her she's fired. Is that Antoinette in the background?
Oh, no.
Oh, okay. I heard someone in the background. Just, geez, settle down.
All right, but you don't have to be scoping out my background.
Okay, well, we already have a GPS on your car, so whatever.
All right.
All right. I'll let you go, I guess.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you for having a much better disposition than Antoinette.
Okay.
You're awesome.
You are, too.
Thanks. Bye. Damn it, I guess she didn't know who Beth was. I guess that's just a personal note in here. I think they were saying they emailed Beth about the situation, but Antoinette does not seem to know Beth. And I was kind of counting on her knowing Beth. You know, like Beth is the regular teacher in the room, and Antoinette is the assistant, and suddenly Beth's putting a GPS on Antoinette's car. But nope, it didn't work. She didn't know Beth. But holy crap, she yelled a lot. Here's a lady named Marcia. She says she's calling in regards to an online application. Caller states that she cannot change her phone number on the site and wishes to get it corrected. So let's help Marcia with her phone issues. I think that's something I can handle.
Hello?
Hello, Marcia?
Yeah?
Hi, it's Dave from the school district, the human resources department.
Uh-huh.
And I see that you changed your phone number here on the website, on the online application thing.
I'm not really sure what you're talking about.
You called a couple weeks ago about you're having a problem changing your number, so I just looked on the application form, and it looks like you changed your number. You're calling on the site.
I called because on the site section screen,
uh-huh.
Like when you pull up my name, it has the wrong phone number. Even for my old phone number, it was incorrect.
Whoa, you have to. Okay, there you go.
So, like, when you first go in and you hit, to site section in general and you hit, I would hit my name and it would come up to where I would load my resume and such.
Mm-hmm.
Are you following me? So that's where there was a discrepancy. And my phone number, that's not even correct for what my old phone number was. So
yeah, well,
that's why I was calling, because I didn't know if that was what principals were viewing.
Right. Well, I show on here that your phone number, it says your phone number is area code 911, and then it says 420. Okay, it says area code 911, then it says 420, and then it says 6969. I mean, come on.
I have no idea what that is.
Oh, come on. That's, you need to grow up. Why would you put that?
Huh?
Why would you put that kind of a phone number on this application? That's silly.
I have no idea what you're talking about. Is what I'm saying.
Oh well, your phone
number that I gave, the woman
mm-hmm.
on the phone to her voice was the phone number that you're calling me on right now.
I see. Yeah. No. It shows on here. Your phone number is 911-420-6969.
I don't know what you're talking about.
That's just immature. On your application here.
I'm sorry. Who am I talking to right now?
Whoa, don't hit touch tones at me. What the hell?
On any application. There is no application.
Well, this is online.
Online where?
On the site, you know, the online application. You're trying to change your phone number. What?
Who is this?
Hey, don't yell at me, motherfucker. I'm calling from the school district. I'm just trying to resolve your issue.
You just cursed at me on the phone.
Well, you were.
So I'm going to ask again for your name, please.
You kind of deserve being cursed at.
That you're talking about, and I didn't write any such phone number.
Yeah, well, you made your area code.
I would like to know your first and last name.
You know what? We have an auto dialing system here at the school district, and if we call your number, it's going to call 911. So you're basically pranked.
How did you just call me then? Because this is not 911.
I know you had a.
How did you just call me?
Oh Jesus Christ!
This is not 911, and I have no idea what you're talking about.
Yeah, well, the first time I called, I called 911, and they yelled at me. They said, "Quit playing on the phone."
Can I have your first and last name? Because I don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah, well, your phone number is a secondary phone number. So
can I have your first and last name? Or not?
No.
Okay, so then this situation is resolved. So your supervisor can call me then if they have a problem.
Well, good.
Because I didn't write any kind
good.
Of number like that.
Well, all I know is you need to grow up and stop putting your phone number as, like, 420, really? Come on, you're a teacher.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
You can't promote drug use around kids. That's terrible.
I have no idea who you are.
Look, quit pretending you don't know what it means.
And you're not telling me who you are. I didn't write any such thing down on any application.
Well, I told you when I first called in. Just scroll back.
Okay.
Scroll back where?
You know, scroll back. You'll see my name.
It doesn't have a name. It has a phone number on my phone right now.
Aren't you?
How would I see a name?
Well, doesn't your cell phone do a transcription of the whole conversation? Most people's do. Just scroll back.
I have no idea if that is possible on my cell phone or not.
Oh, you just don't know how to use it because you're spending too much time with the 420.
Well, I don't know who you are, but I didn't write any such a thing down.
911-420-6969.
Well, I heard you for the 400th time. What? I'm not having this conversation. If your supervisor would like to speak to me, I would really like to speak to them. Otherwise, I'm assuming this is a prank call of some kind.
No.
You're not giving me your first last name or your position.
No, I did at the beginning. So, I just don't like repeating myself.
Well, then you would state it clearly again.
Well,
if
I just...
If this was any kind of validity to this conversation.
I feel like...
I didn't apply to anywhere with any such a number.
I feel like if you weren't such a stoner, you would know my name. Because I said it very clearly at the beginning. It's just a pet peeve of mine. I don't like repeating myself.
Well, I'm a stoner, and you're not telling me who you are.
I mean, you
but
know,
you're calling me on my personal cell phone.
Well, that's...
Have a good night, sir.
Well, don't hang up. Come on. Okay, you guys. This is live now. It's no longer pre-recorded. I'm sorry all of you are so upset about that in the chat room. Sorry. Jeez. The nerve of me playing brand new calls for you on a live show. What was I thinking? Why would I do something like that? Anyway, someone submitted this list to me, and I still have a ton of numbers from it. So I was thinking we could spend an hour or so calling teachers from this list, and hopefully they'll pick up. You know, hopefully they'll be around and they're not busy being in a classroom teaching. So that's what we're going to do today. There's this one that I see I don't really want to call it, but I want to read this to you guys. This lady, she's a classroom assistant, and her note thing here says, wants to change schools, doctor advising her to leave position, caller wants to change schools now. So that sounds like a really bad situation. And I don't want to call her because she sounds like a mess, you know? I'll probably, like, send her over the edge. She'd probably kill herself right on the phone with me. That would suck. Yes, Cosmic Pursuits, I watched the chat. There is a chat room. If you're listening to this and you want to be in the chat room, I'm broadcasting today on two different things. I'm broadcasting on Shoutcast, which it looks like 31 people are currently listening to. And I'm also broadcasting on YouTube, where we have 70 people watching. And if you go to the YouTubes, just go to phonelosers.org/live. And you can go to the YouTube, and you can watch video, and you can go to the chat room. And if you're at phonelosers.org/live, you have to click on the YouTubes and bring up the chat room that way. Hopefully you know that. Fucking idiot. So anyway, let's get to this list thing. Gotta figure out where to start first. I think I'm gonna start with the most recent calls. So we got a guy named Bruno. He's an accountant. Oh, wait a minute. What the hell? He's an accountant with the Department of Revenue. He sent his resume 6 months ago, following up to see if any open positions. Really itching to work there. And he's with the Department of Revenue. I don't know, where could we go with that? That's weird. So let's give this guy a try. He wants to quit working for the IRS. Go into teaching. Alright, here goes. I mean, what should I say to this guy? I don't even know. This is a weird one.
Hello?
Hello, Bruno?
Who's calling?
This is Roy from the school district here in the Human Resources Department. I was just returning your call. Looks like you called in. You're interested in a position?
I'm sorry. When was this? When did I call in?
Looks like yesterday, didn't you?
No, I don't believe I did. Yesterday.
Well, when did you call in? Is that a trick question, or what's...
I don't remember doing this. I'm very confused here.
You're blacked out or something, I guess. Using
Excuse
drugs?
Me?
Were you blacked out using drugs or drinking or something?
Who is this?
This is Roy from the school district and the human resources department. It says here that you called in yesterday. It says you sent your resume 6 months ago.
I don't know what you're talking about, sir.
You didn't send a resume 6 months ago?
No, I did not. Not the school district.
Well, you sent a resume to the school, though. And I'm calling from the district. We do the calls for them. But didn't you call in yesterday? It says right here. My secretary says you called in. Why would she write this down? Is she just fucking with me?
Who is this?
Oh, for the third time, my name is Roy. I'm calling from the Human Resources Department. For the school district?
Well, I seriously doubt you're calling from the school district because you're cursing on the line. Okay, it's not very professional. So I'd just like to know who's calling.
Oh, I actually really am calling from the school district. I don't think you're very professional. You're the one that's, you know, saying you want to work here and then pretending you never even called. We have caller ID. It shows right here that you called. It shows incoming caller ID, and it has your number.
Okay, I'd like to know who this is.
Is it maybe someone in your family playing a joke on you? Like, teehee, we'll get Bruno. we'll make him think he wants a job here. Okay, that was weird. Why is he saying he didn't call? It's right here. The hell? Fucking Bruno. Tyler wants me to call him a stupid head. Hey, Bruno, if you don't want this $850,000 a year job, then whatever, you know, I'll give it to someone else. You big stupid head. You big stupid head. Have fun working for the Department of Revenue for the rest of your life, motherfucker. Well, we're making the big bucks over here. Here at the school district. Hello, Bruno? Bruno? All right, Bruno, I'm hanging up so I can call somebody else and give them the job. You lose. No job for you. Hanging up now. Here I go. I'm really going to do it. Hanging up the phone. That was me slamming down my phone. My 1970s era phone. Bye, Bruno. Alright, he's gone. He's just sitting there, not saying anything. Attention, chat room. Please don't post numbers in the chat room. Because I don't want you to. And I'm not going to call any numbers you put in the chat room. I know everyone's going to post numbers now. Just to be smartasses. But I'm not going to call any of them, so please don't do that. I'm starting a Kickstarter today to get myself a new office chair that doesn't squeak a bunch. So if you'd like to contribute to that, it's on the website. Next, Felicia is a bus attendant. Oh, look at that, a billion people posting numbers in the chat room. She says she's calling to get more info on 504... And then in parentheses it says sick leave. And FMLA transfer... Oh, never mind. She transferred her to personnel. So what can we say to a bus attendant who's calling to get more sick leave? I'll try not to curse at her so I seem more professional, I guess.
Hi, I'm not available at the present time.
Damn it. I love the ideas in the chat room and she's not going to pick up. I like the how many buses can you attend at one time? Efficiency is key here. Alma wants me to say, tell her you can't get her a 504, but you can give her a good 69. Wink, wink.
Hi, I'm not available at the present time.
Balls.
Leave me a...
All right, let me put a note on this one. She's not picking up her Cricket wireless phone. Milk Brain says, how many words per minute can you text while driving? Damn it. Okay, we've got a classroom assistant. She's calling in regards to payroll and not being in the system. That sounds like a Milton situation from Office Space. Hello, Gianna?
Yeah.
Oh, hey, this is Roy from the school district, the human resources department. You called about not being in the payroll system?
Yes.
And it looks like we put you in the real teacher system instead of the pretend teachers. Yeah, we put you in the wrong. We put you in the wrong one. We have like two different.
Okay.
We have two different systems. One is for real teachers, and one is for the pretend teachers who are just assistants. The ones that, you know, the ones that don't really do anything. They just go around collecting papers or whatever. We had you in the wrong system. Stupid us.
Okay.
You're not very talkative. Are you okay?
Yes.
Okay. Well, I just wanted to let you know what was going on with the payroll.
Okay.
That's all you're going to say is okay? Come on, can't you yell at me or something?
No, because you just made a mistake. It's okay.
Yeah, well, it's not, I didn't make the mistake. It was Chad.
Oh, whoever made the mistake.
Yeah, Chad. He works in payroll, and he accidentally put you in the real teachers database, and we can't. That means you would get like real money and everything.
Me. Yep. There's no reason to yell at him. All you guys have to do is fix it.
Oh, I didn't yell at him. I went in there and I hit him in the back of the head. I'm like, Chad, you stupid motherfucker. And he's got it all fixed now. You're going to get your pretend money.
Okay.
Yep. What you doing right now? Are you teaching?
No, the class, they're playing a game before they have computers.
Oh, I see. What kind of game?
Silent ball, I think.
Salad ball?
Silent ball.
Violent ball?
Silent.
Oh, silent.
I don't know. They're like throwing. They're like throwing the ball back and forth.
Okay.
Each other.
We're gonna need you to test the system. Is there any way you could run into the middle of the game right now?
Is there any way I can run into the middle of the game right now?
Yeah, just jump up, hold your cell phone, kind of run into the middle of whatever they're doing. Try not to get hit, and scream at the top of your lungs. I am the true lord of the dance.
No, I don't want to bother them. They're playing so well.
Yeah, but you need to shake things up around there if you want to become a real teacher. You know?
Yes.
All right. They also wanted me to tell you that you're not allowed to smoke weed on school premises, like not even in the teacher's lounge.
That's fine, because I don't smoke at all, so...
Well, no, they said they caught you smoking weed, and I know our country's getting progressive with the whole weed thing lately, but you can't be doing that in the teacher's lounge. There's a time and a place for everything.
Okay, I'll go down the street next time.
Yeah, please do.
I don't smoke.
Just go out and back with the rest of the kids.
Okay,
well, bye.
All right, thank you.
Sure. God. Everybody sucks today. Nobody's reacting at all. I wish I could play commercial music. Someone just quoted a certain Van Halen song that really needs to be played. Alright, so this next one, there's no note. Should I call this one? Yeah, there's not really a note. Forget this one. Forget I said anything. Wow, there's only 10 minutes of show left, and then I'm leaving. That's too bad. Let's try and get as many calls in as I can. Caller's principal wanted her to apply for a social work position. Doesn't see it as an option. Was asked to call HR. Looked on website for caller. It is an open position, but can't find on website. It's not listed. Danielle didn't pick up line. What the f- I don't even know what all this is. I don't know. I think I kind of want to skip that one. I don't know what's going on with that. Here, let me scroll through here and see if I can find a lunch lady. That'd be kind of awesome. We're going to call Rianne. She works in the food service. She wanted to talk to Linda. But she doesn't really have an issue listed here, so...
Hello?
Oh, shit. Hold on, you guys. Hold on. Oh, wait. I'm sorry. Is this Rianne?
Yes, it is.
Holy shit, you're screaming into your phone.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh, I'm calling from the school district. You called to talk to Linda?
Yes.
So are you a lunch lady?
Yes.
Okay, are you the head lunch lady?
Yes.
Do you make the sloppy joes there? Do you make them extra sloppy?
The sloppy joes?
Yeah, do you ever do sloppy joes?
Oh, I don't recall the last time we ever served sloppy joes.
Ah, you gotta make them extra sloppy. The kids like them extra sloppy. Because we had some complaints, and they were saying you weren't making the sloppy joes sloppy enough. And that's bullshit.
Oh, really?
It's bullshit, ma'am. It's bullshit.
And that's the reason for your phone call?
Yeah, I just, I work here at the front desk here at the school district, and I just saw that you'd called, and, I don't know. I have no idea why I'm calling, actually. I'm a little drunk. I'm really sorry.
Oh, okay.
You know.
Well, I'm gonna let you go.
What are you gonna do? Where are you going? What are you doing? Okay. All right, so I got all flustered there because I just found out that Matt and Zax are doing a show right now. And I swear to God, when I started my show, I checked istthereashow.com. There was no show happening. And Matt says there's a civil war that's getting ready to start. Let's see. They've been doing it for 30 minutes over on mixler.com/prankcallnation. Oops. Sorry, guys. Sorry. So that's the reason I just kind of went nowhere with that call. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm gonna keep doing this until 11 o'clock. Exactly 11. That's in 25 minutes. So I'm going to do as many calls as I can in 25 minutes. What the hell, Matt and Zax? I didn't think you did shows this early. I thought it was safe for me to do early shows. God damn it. Hold on. Let's see what's happening on their show real quick. Because that's a good idea. Wasting my precious 25 minutes listening to their show.
Someone else is being either snails or like... Someone's been around, but it's just us. Just us.
Well, they have 21 listeners.
Yay! Back to the roots.
Yay. Yeah. Well,
they're doing all right.
For the patriarchy. Be involved in the Civil War.
They're talking about Civil Wars, you guys.
Civil War. But we've had a great great week on Patreon. We have another person.
Okay, so yeah. Silly me. All right, let's make calls, you guys. We've got a lot of shit to do all of a sudden. We've got a long way to go and a short time to get there. That's what I'm trying to say. Let's see. Did I just see food service? I thought I saw food service. Oh, shit. Food service. You guys, food service. Just sent a fax and wanted to know if we received it. Act. What does that mean? Advised to contact employee records directly. Okay, well, I'm going to call from employee records. This should be good, because I'm going to tell her what was on that fax. It was a picture of extra sloppy Joes. Yeah, that's it.
I'm out.
Hello, Edwina?
Who's calling?
I'm calling from the school district. I'm in the employee records department, and we got this fax from you that I was a little confused about.
Yes.
Why'd you fax this to us?
It's a 168 form. Y'all faxed it back.
Oh, no, this isn't a 168 form. I think you faxed the wrong thing to us.
No, I faxed the 168 form.
Oh.
And y'all faxed it back to the school, the school already, because they called and let me know they had it.
Oh, they have it all right. No, we faxed it back to them because we were trying to make a complaint about you. But the thing you faxed to us, you faxed us like 25 pages of pornography.
Pornography?
Yeah, pornography, like naked pictures.
I didn't fax it. I took that to the fax machine.
No. I have the faxes right here. Right here. 25 pages of pornography.
But it's not me. I didn't fax you anything. I wouldn't have my paperwork done someplace at a store.
Well, why would a store allow you to fax all this pornography like that? That's
weird. They did the faxing. I had them over my paperwork, and they did the faxing.
Oh, so they're the ones that faxed the 25 pages of pornography to us?
They must have, because I didn't fax you anything.
Well, no, you just said you faxed over a 168.
Hold up, sir.
So the story changes,
no,
doesn't it?
No, I did not.
First, you didn't...
No, I took it to an auto place where they sell where you get your tags at.
An auto
store? I gave them what... What's the name of that tag place, Tala? I took it up on... Cold Street to a tag place where you get your tags at.
Oh, hell if I know. Look, all I know is you can't fax this pornography, ma'am. That's inappropriate.
I didn't fax you anything there.
You said you faxed us a 168 form.
Listen. The job gave me a 168 form. I took it to a place. They faxed it over to the school board for me. Philadelphia School District. They faxed it over for me. Charged me $2 to do it.
$2 to fax 25 pages of pornography?
I don't know nothing about no pornography, sir.
Well, that's what we have here is 25 pages of pornography.
Well, then I don't know where that comes from.
And you know what? It doesn't when you do. Hey, don't be a smartass. No, when you fax pornography, it doesn't even look.
Smartass, who is this?
It doesn't even look good. Like I took it home with me last night, and
yeah.
I tried to whack off to it, and it was like yeah, it's
oh,
just.
The hell
and
is
and you
this?
Know what? Like when you put your fingers on the fax paper.
This man said I had some.
Will you stop? Hey, you're being rude. You're being rude, lady. Stop talking to someone else. You're on the phone.
Talking about what's from the school board.
I'm in employee records. My name is Roy.
He said he's an employee record from the school board.
Hey, will you stop being rude, lady? Stop being rude.
What's your name, sir?
Well, who the fuck are you? I'm calling about Edwina's faxes that she sent to us here in the.
I'm my husband. What you talking about, man? Why you have to use so much vulgar language?
Oh, I'm using vulgar language. She's the one that faxed over a bunch of porn to us.
Well, I'm not. I'm talking to you now. I'm not using that.
Okay.
I asked you, what's your name?
Well, I don't even know who fuck you are. I mean, who are you? You don't have anything to do with the school.
Well, I'll tell you like this, man. Since you can't use. If
you sound like you're not allowed within 500 feet of a school.
You don't want to sound like that, man. You're funny,
really?
Too.
Oh, really?
Have a good day.
Is that why I work at the school district, motherfucker? All right, let's call them right back. What should I say? We're filing charges for the pornography here.
Hello?
Hey, look, if you fax more pornography to us, can you at least fax good pornography?
I'm going to call the school board right now because I don't understand. I just took a 168 form to a tag place, and they faxed me, faxed over some work to be filled out and faxed back to a job for me.
Maybe.
I don't know about all the other stuff you're talking about.
Yeah. No, we got pornography from the same phone number that your 168 form came in, and that's not appropriate.
Here's the thing.
And who was that stupid guy on the phone? Was that one of the guys in the porn?
That's the that's my husband. I'm calling the school board. Bye. That's all I can do. Bye.
Well, no, don't hang up yet. No, don't hang up.
No, I'm
we have more to talk about. There's another issue. Damn it. Oh, I didn't get to ask her about the Sloppy Joes. Damn it. Oh, what? Oh, here we go. Wait, this could be good. Her name is Shilpa. What the hell kind of name is that? Calling because pharmacist says pay $30 for a RX. Wants to look at her benefits plan. It says who they transferred to. The only problem with this one is the location. We don't know where they work or what their position is. So, yeah, let's call this lady about her benefits.
Thank you for calling. You will now be connected to the person you dialed.
Well, what? What? What's happening? It's got put on hold. Shit.
Hello, I'm connecting your call. One moment, please. The number's ringing.
What? You're not real, are you?
Yes, I am. You called a person that uses sign language to communicate, and I'll interpret the call for you once we've connected.
Okay, that sounds great.
Okay.
Who are you trying to connect me to?
I don't know. It's the number you dialed.
No. Don't do that. We're on the air, lady.
I beg your pardon?
You heard. Yeah, never mind. It's okay. Yeah, just whatever.
Okay, your call just got answered by an answering machine.
Fuck.
And the person isn't available.
Fuck.
Would you like to leave a message?
No, it's okay.
Okay. Would you like me to redial?
Nah, she's probably not home.
Okay.
She's out turning tricks.
Okay, thank you.
All right, bye.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Goodbye. All right. What the hell was that, you guys? And we're... That was very odd. I don't know what just happened. I think we need to tune in to Matt's show and see what's happening there.
Roy, let's see.
Maybe it was an attack from the prank.
Maybe. Yeah.
Uh-oh.
Boom.
They think we're making attacks on him now, you guys.
Going hard and heavy.
Civil War.
Shots fired at our bow.
2016.
Oh, shit. Evasive maneuver. Hard starboard.
All right. I'm going to turn that off. I'm just going to quit my show and go join their show. Their show sounds like more fun. Let's see. Support staff positions. We've got 11 minutes to do this, you guys. Recently resigned on April 15th. Says it was accepted. Time period to rescind. Told caller a day before resignation date.
Hello?
Hi, Jennifer?
Yes, this is she.
Hey, Jennifer. I'm calling from the school district. I'm in the HR department.
Yes.
And we saw that you'd called about your resignation that was accepted.
Yes.
And it turns out it wasn't actually accepted. That was an April Fool's joke. It was a late April's
joke. It was... Excuse me?
It was a late April Fool's joke.
So it wasn't accepted?
No, it was just a joke. They were just joking. They accepted the resignation, but then they were immediately like, April Fool's, and didn't accept it.
Oh, really?
Yeah, they were just joking, just joshing with you. what'd you want to resign for anyway? Don't you like your job?
I love it, but I'm relocating.
Where are you relocating to?
D.C.
Oh, well, you can't leave. Your resignation is not accepted. They put like a red stamp on it. It says not accepted. April Fool's joke.
It has to be.
Well, I'm sorry, it's not. We need more. We don't have enough teachers, and we just can't accept it right now. Maybe next year. Try again next year.
I can't.
Why not? What are you doing that's so important? Why do you have to leave? Where are you going? What are you doing?
I just explained.
Well, you said you're leaving. You didn't explain why.
Marriage.
Well, make him move. Like, why can't he move?
He was here.
Well, make him stay longer.
I mean,
I was imitating your laugh. Sorry. Go ahead.
That's okay.
Anyway.
Hello?
Yeah. Anyway, April Fools, no resignation for you.
So what do I have to do?
You have to stay there indefinitely.
I won't be able to do that.
Well, then you're going to be in violation. You won't get any benefits.
Okay. I'll have to take that chance.
Where are you moving to?
D.C.
Oh, yeah. You already said that. Sorry. I'm a little bit high. What are you going to be doing there? Are you going to be a teacher? Or are you going to be like a prostitute?
Yes, I'm going to be a teacher.
Oh, why are you letting your man control you?
I'm not. Is this a joke?
No. Well, yeah, the resignation exception was a joke. April Fools. But no, I was just wondering,
okay.
why are you letting your man control you? Why don't you say, hey, I'm a strong woman, and
I'm not doing that. Is there another reason why you called?
Just to say that they were just joking. They were just joking over in the resignation department.
Okay.
Yep, that's all it was, just a joke. So you're staying here. You're not going to D.C.
All right, thank you.
And don't let your man control you. If he wants to control you like that, you shouldn't marry him. Because it's just going to get worse. He's just going to keep doing it. It's going to just keep escalating.
Thanks a lot.
Yeah, well, so you can't leave.
Okay, thank you.
All right, well, have a nice day, honey.
All right.
Honey baby. Hey, are you going to be single soon? Are you? Oh, man. I think she'll know that one was a joke. Because I told her it's a joke. April Fools, right? All right. We have 7 minutes. Oh, quick, let's tune into the Civil War, see what's happening.
I need you to pimp my ride. My ride, it doesn't look good. I need to pimp my ride.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, they hung up.
Oh, my God, and I hung up.
I wonder if they're tuning in into my show and checking on the status of the Civil War on this end. Let's call them up and tell them they're going down.
Side man.
Hey, Civil War motherfuckers, you're going
Trojan
down.
Horse.
What's
going
up,
down.
Buddy?
Fuck you both and your stupid show, motherfuckers.
Ouch.
Civil War 2016. Woo! All right. Now we gotta see their response. Quick, let's listen.
That was good.
Yeah.
Yep, I won that round.
That was good.
Apparently it was good, you guys.
That was the best call of the show so far.
You know what?
Best call of the show. Thanks,
bro.
Yay, I made their show better.
Legitimately the best call so far.
Alright. Let's call this person in my last 5 minutes. Her name is Holia. Recently contacted by a school in the district. Told her to give us a call about the salary. Erica told me to transfer her. Okay, I don't understand any of that.
Hello?
Hello, Holia?
Hi.
Hello?
Hello?
Oh, hi, I'm calling from the school district. I'm in the human resources department. I was calling about your salary.
Yes.
And I just needed to let you know, we're going to have to, you're not going to get a salary anymore. We're just doing some cutbacks, and we're going to have to stop doing your salary thing. Sorry.
What?
Your salary. We can't do a salary anymore. We can't afford it because we hired some new...
Who is this?
I'm calling from the school district. I'm in the human resources department. And
right.
Yep. We can't do...
I don't have a job right yet.
Well, yeah, but if you get one, you're not going to get a salary.
I'm not going to get paid?
Yeah, it'll just be like volunteer work. But you'll be doing a good thing, you know, for the kids. You'll be helping the kids. Like, see, we have, like, a quota for, you know, men versus women and all the different races and stuff. And we have too many women right now. We can't have this many women. There's no male teachers.
What is your name?
My name is Roy. But here's the good news. Your salary is going to be replaced with free school meal vouchers. And you can sleep in the school classroom for a week. And we've hired illegals to be your replacement. It's much cheaper that way.
You're confusing me. I'm a little confused as to who this is.
My name is Roy. I'm calling from the Human Resources Department with the school district. I was calling to let you know that...
Right, I understand that, but this seems like a joke.
No, it's not a joke. We don't joke here, ma'am. Education is a serious thing.
You're part of the school district and your name is Roy.
Yep, Roy Gerbel from the Human Resources Department. So, yeah, what position were you applying for anyway?
Science teacher.
Oh, damn it. We really need a bus driver right now. Would you be a bus driver?
No.
Shit. Lunch lady. We definitely need a lunch lady.
No, I applied for a science teaching position, and they offered me a position.
Yeah, but you're not going to get paid. It's going to be volunteer work. I mean, science...
Since when?
Starting now. I mean, we don't really need to teach... We don't need that many science teachers, to be honest. We're more of a...
Since when?
We're more
Your whole thing on...
Well, we're just...
So if I contact a school that is offering to hire me, they're going to say that you're a legitimate person right now?
Of course, yeah. Roy Gerbel from Human Resources. We're leaning more towards creationism these days, so we don't really need the science.
So, I'm so confused. Roy, how do you spell your last name?
Gerbelle.
B-H?
Yep, B-H. It's foreign. Don't be a racist. Come on.
I'm a little, you're really being, so CH, what is it?
Well, I don't have to show the same amount of respect to volunteer teachers as I do to real teachers, so.
What's your last name? Can you give me the last name?
Yeah, Gerbel.
CH.
Yeah, Yellow Submarine respelled it for me. Thank you, Yellow Submarine. It's Gerbelle.
Gerbel.
Yep.
Okay, well, I think we're done talking at the moment.
Do you know much about creationism, ma'am?
I think we're done talking at the moment. I will get back to you.
Have you ever considered being a fundamentalist preacher?
I will talk to you at some other point. Thank you.
Why are you going to talk to me? Like, I think we're done.
Because I'm not really agreeing with what you're saying right now to me.
Well, you don't get a choice.
I want to contact some other people and find out who exactly you are.
If you don't agree, you know, go find a job somewhere else.
So, thank you.
In your fancy, science-y stuff. All right. She didn't like that. Let's tune in on the enemies, see what they're doing.
Oh, look at this awesome. Lisa, look out, it's Skeleton. That's my favorite line from The Simpsons. Or one of them.
Fucking Matt, quoting lines from The Simpsons.
Lisa, look out, it's Skeleton. I love that
God. All right, so it's 11:01. I know I said I'm quitting right at 11, but you know what? Fuck those motherfuckers. I'm going to do one more call, and then I'm going to quit. And then all of you are going to stop listening to me, and you're going to go listen to Matt. And in fact, I'm going to jump on Matt's show and try and fuck it all up. I think I might do that for a little bit. Oh, holy shit, you guys. I think we just found something really good. I didn't see this one before. I'm going to do another live show, you guys. I've got so many of these teacher numbers. Okay. This is going to be the last call, and he's probably not going to pick up, so this is going to suck. Coach at a high school. This is... The caller's name is anonymous. The school name is anonymous. But the phone number is not anonymous. Coach at a high school doesn't want to be identified. Says he's discussed confidential information with us before, and it somehow leaked back to his school. Holy shit, he's not going to be happy about this. started out as a volunteer coach, then took a coach's exam and passed. Caller proceeded to lament a 30-minute rant, continuing after being asked several times what the point of the call was. Caller said he was cornered in the athletic director. He cornered the athletic director on the baseball field because he was told he needed to talk to the AD before coming down to 440. Was told still has to fill coaching positions. Says we need to have a better system. Current system pins somebody down. Doesn't know what to do because he doesn't want to make public relations enemies with the athletic director. Caller is passing on some kind of suggestion, completely unsure of actual point of call. Sounds like a prank call or something. But his number is right here, even though he was completely anonymous. Oh, in fact, before I do this, I'm going to type this number into Facebook. See what his name is. Ah, it's not there. That's too bad. Anyway, yeah, let's do this, and then I'm going to quit for the day, and I'm going to go listen to Matt's show.
Hello?
Hello. I'm calling from the Human Resources Department here at the school district.
Uh-huh.
And I've been talking to the athletic director over there about your problem. And he says, you know, he was just like, he was very rude about it. He said he's sick of your shit. And he's like, you know what? I'm going to corner him on the field soon. And we're going to have some words, me and him.
Well, I didn't ask anybody to talk to him because I didn't want this kind of static.
Well, yeah, but, you know, I thought I'd get his side of the story. There's always two sides to a story.
Yeah, but I never officially gave my name. I never officially authorized this.
Yeah, but he knows who it is. It's okay. He knows.
Yeah, but I didn't authorize to go through this.
I know. I didn't tell him your name because I don't know
you're
it.
You're not in my shoes.
I wouldn't want to be in your shoes, in your smelly athletic shoes. Gross. Ew.
You know?
Ew, gross. Athletic shoes?
You didn't do me any favors by doing it.
Well, we're just trying to help. We're just trying to make things better.
You know, I mean, now what protection do I have against the repercussions now?
Oh, okay. Well, listen, I was just kidding. I didn't really talk to the athletic director. I just thought it'd be funny to say that because you called in and ranted for like 30 minutes yesterday.
No, it's not funny. You're talking to a grown man. You're a grown man. I'm a grown man. I'm an adult. I'm a grandfather. I'm a husband.
I'm pretty immature.
I got children, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
And I've been going to school this school for 24 years.
Well, I was just...
There's nothing fine. You know, we work so hard to have some policies.
I was just kidding, though. You know, I was just kidding. I don't want to hear your dumb rant again. Look, you just... I was kidding about the athletic director thing. I didn't really talk to him. He won't talk to me anymore anyway.
If you guys can't do anything about it, you know, the only thing I able to do is to just what's the word? Try to have some closure.
Whoa, is that a threat? Situation. Is that a threat? You know, you don't need to threaten us.
No, I'm saying I'm just trying to have some closure with how the process.
Oh,
is
closure.
You know,
closure.
Closure.
Like, are
closure.
You are you doing air quotes as you say that? Is that what you're doing? Air quotes. Hello?
You still there?
Yeah, I'm still here. What's up, coach?
Yeah, you have some questions to ask me?
I just thought it'd be funny to call and tell you we told on you. We tattled to the athletic director.
Okay. All right. Is that it?
Well, no, I have some other things. Disclosure, does that mean fist fight? I just want to make sure you're not making a threat.
No, I don't go around threatening people.
Okay. Because I only spoke to the janitor and the science teacher about this whole thing with you. And they're like, ugh, yeah, that guy.
Well, you know, I am in the classroom and I am working. Really? You know, that was my lunch break when I was talking to them.
Oh, my God. You spent your entire lunch break yelling at us on the phone? Hey, can you tell that person in the background to shut the fuck up? Tell him or her, men talking. Damn kids, they got to learn. Hello, coach?
What is your goal? What is your goal?
Oh, I don't have goals. I'm not a gym teacher. Come on.
What is your goal? What are you trying to achieve right now?
Nothing. I was trying to make a joke, and you don't even seem to think it's funny.
Okay. Well, I need to finish this conversation.
Okay. What are you doing today? What are you teaching? What's the topic for today?
Bye bye.
No, I just
bye-bye.
Have to make I'm sure. Done. I'm supposed to make sure that you're not gonna have closure.
Bye.
Or anything like that. That was boring and stupid. And I couldn't use chat room ideas because you were all just talking about molestation and child predators and whatever else you guys were saying. I'm not going to say that stuff. Your body problem is scaring the children, sir. Say the principal set him up for a prank. ABC. It's not principal, it's principal. It's your principal. It's principal. Remember that. All right, it's 11:08, you guys. I don't need my house swatted. Let's see what Matt and Zax are doing.
So I said give numbers.
Yeah.
Oh, it sounds like they're talking
any
about
any numbers sent or called. Guaranteed. Seal of approval.
So that's the end of the show. I think we need to give a call to Matt. Or hold on here. I want to give you guys the link to listen to the show on Prank Call Nation, if you'd like to do that. I just posted it in the chat room. Pasted it, I mean.
Yeah, it's good. It's a good site. A lot of cool people.
You guys are going down. You're going down, motherfuckers.
I like to pop the show when the phone rings. You on Facebook.
Hey, motherfuckers.
It really rolls off the tongue.
Hey, motherfuckers. Going down.
Smooth.
God damn it.
It's me.
Can you guys not hear me? Hello? I'm trying to make threats.
Oh, wait. Forgot one.
Hey. Hey.
Hey.
God damn it.
Who's talking?
It's me.
Oh, Brad Carter, what's up, buddy?
I'm trying to make threats, goddammit.
Oh, okay.
You guys are going down.
Oh.
I think we've done it to ourselves because every single call so far has been.
Hey, everyone. RBCP here. This is pre-recorded RBCP. And that's the end of the live show today. I mean, it's the end of my live show. But I actually jumped on the Party Time show and joined Laugh Track Matt and Zax for some calls. We called some more school people. So basically, the show has a sequel, and you can listen to that sequel by either going, I don't know which place to go to anymore, since Prank Call Nation is kind of disbanded, but they're still using the stuff for it. So either go to prankcallnation.com or go to mixler.com/prankcallnation and look for the Party Time show for May 12th, 2016. Or actually, you know what would probably be the best way to find it is to go to facebook.com/ilikethepartoftheshowwhenthephonerings. And I assume they will post about the new show when it's put up. Laugh Track Matt and Zax, they do a show at least once a week, usually. And usually not quite so early, so this whole Civil War thing is their fault, not mine. Because I think they usually go on at like 2 p.m. or something, and I did my show at like 9 or 10 this morning. So if they try to tell you it's my fault, those motherfuckers are lying and cannot be trusted. Oh yeah, also today we called the Jitterbug cell phone company and tricked them out of customer information. So I don't know if any of you remember that from a couple of years ago when I was on the Party Time show and we fucked with Jitterbug a lot. But we did that again today and it was kind of amusing, I guess, sort of. So go listen to the Party Time show right now, it's the sequel. Or you could just stick around and listen to some voicemails. Before I start the voicemails, though, I need to remind everyone to please support the Snowplow Show by going to phonelosers.org/cactus or patreon.com/phonelosers. Either of those places let you sign up for a small monthly donation to the show, which helps support the show and hopefully makes more shows happen. And if all goes well, maybe I'll just do these shows full time and you guys will never run out of shows. And I know I've been saying that forever, but you know what? The amounts haven't really changed too much over the past year or year and a half. I mean, they have changed. They've been slowly going up, but it's been slowly is the problem. So we need to get tons more people listening to the show and tons more people supporting the show. And maybe someday I'll be doing like 23 shows a week. And that would be awesome. And one thing I've been doing for supporters lately is I've been making videos of the show on the live shows because I've been broadcasting on YouTube. So not only can you hear a completely unedited show from today, but you can also watch video of it. You can see me on camera for most of it. I think I forgot to turn on the camera for about half of today's show, but I'm on there on the second half. But the really cool part of it, in my opinion, is that you can watch the chat room as you're listening to the show. So you can see who suggests which things that I say in the pranks. And you can see all of the horrible things that people suggest that I kind of ignore, even though I laugh at the horrible suggestions. So support the show, phonelosers.org/cactus or patreon.com/phonelosers.
Hello, Rick here. Got some advice for you. A couple of shows ago, you did a call where you were waking the people up in the middle of the night and telling them, wanted to do a customer survey or whatnot. I think that's simple but awesome, and I think you're going to get nothing but awesome responses from that, or at least the people who answer. I would stick to it. I know it's a, like I said, it's a simple concept.
I'll do it just
so
for you.
Simple. It's genius. So stick with that, man. Do that more.
I'm going to do nothing but that on my show from now on.
And
every single show.
I don't even think you have to be, come up with real crazy surveys or ideas. Just moderately piss them off. I mean, they're already pissed because they woke up anyway. And that's pretty much it. Cactus and vote for Trump.
Yay, Trump.
Hi, Brad. It's high school graduate. I think Katy Perry will have a new album released this year, which means she'll go on tour again soon. Mm-hmm. If I buy you a ticket to the show, will you go to Katy Perry's show with me?
Okay.
Thank you. I love your episodes. And I'm a
Why wouldn't
Patreon
I?
Supporter too. Have a good night.
Oh, and he says he's a Patreon supporter, so of course I would go to a Katy Perry concert with you. I'd be crazy to turn down something like that.
Hey, Roy, it's me, NY guy. Sorry about last call. I was mumbling like a retard. I was at work. I was in the bathroom. I didn't feel like
excuses
to everyone that was around me. So yeah. Anyway,
yep. Well.
A lot of people have been asking you to do those nuclear bunker family things. The calls that people hiding underground. They've been there since the 60s.
I am not going to forget to do that. By the way, I have it in my notes. And I love that idea, and I definitely have to do that. And I also want to do more lost calls. I love having my very own Hatch computer.
I was thinking maybe after Dinktember, you can do Nukember, maybe? I don't know.
Okay.
Anyway, text, keep pranking, keep calling. Have a nice day.
Thanks! I don't know if I'm up for an entire month of nuclear bunker calls, but I'm definitely going to do more of those soon.
Hey, Brad. I was just curious, watching a show called The Voice.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sure you've heard of it, the singing show.
What? No.
And Pharrell's on there.
I can imagine what it's like, though. It's probably like all the other singing shows.
And he's always wearing handmade shirts that say cactus on them, or he's got, a beanie that has cactus.
For Pharrell, he's a big fan of the Snowplow show.
Just written on there with the Sharpie. Just curious if he's potentially getting that name from you, man.
Yep.
You fucking rock. Keep it up, buddy.
Yep. I've been sending those shirts to Pharrell. Me and him go way back. I didn't think anyone would notice, though. And I really haven't seen The Voice before. I've never even heard of it. But I'm guessing it's like American Idol, and I'm just not really into reality TV at all. I bet your show is stupid, and you should stop watching it, because it's taking away from your Snowplow show listening time.
Hey, Brad. I've been listening to your show for a while, like a whole 5 weeks now. So I guess you can say I'm a veteran.
Wow.
I just wanted to...
It's crazy.
I had a question, what made you decide to start calling people hobos? Because that's just, really fucking funny.
There's a good answer for that. The reason I started calling people hobos is because they're being fucking hobos. And it pisses me off.
You should make more hang-up-the-phone prank calls. Those are, really fucking hilarious. Anyways, bye!
Bye.
Hang up the phone.
No, you hang up.
Hang up the fucking phone.
You hang up the phone, motherfucker. You hang up first, or I'll hang it up for you. I'm pretty sure I remember exactly when I started calling people hobos. If I remember correctly, it's the very first time I called a bunch of residents in a rich neighborhood, which was the neighborhood of Atherton, California, the one with the historic wall. And I think that happened even before I started doing official snowplow shows. I think this was during the time I was just doing random shows before other people's shows, with titles like the Four Loko and Tostito Show or whatever I called them. But I spent hours putting together that list of rich people in Atherton. And as I was getting the numbers and the street view images and everything, I was jotting notes down on what I could say about their lawns. And I don't know why, but for whatever reason, I decided to start telling them that they looked like hobos. Or, you know, they made the neighborhood look like a bunch of hobos lived there. And I don't know where that came from. It just, after I thought of it, I decided it was really hilarious because it makes no sense. Hobos don't have houses. They don't live in neighborhoods. It's the stupidest thing I could possibly say to people. So as far as I know, that is the origin of the whole hobo thing that I've been doing for way too long and running into the ground now. And by the way, that bit of trivia there, that would go great on the Phone Losers of America wiki page, which is located at phonelosers.org/wiki, but I'm too lazy to stop the show right now, to stop recording and go write it down, so that's where you guys come in. One of you, you need to go to the wiki page and sign up for an account. I made it so you have to sign up for an account now. Sorry about that. I know it's annoying, but I think we all know that that's for the best. Anyway, go to the wiki page, create an account, and create an entry or something about the origin of the word hobo. That is everyone's homework assignment tonight. Go to the wiki page, make an entry about hobos, and then all of them except for one will be deleted. Probably.
Alright, so, this time I wrote down my concern.
Okay.
So,
I love when people write down the voicemails so that they can read them from a piece of paper. It sounds so natural when you guys do that.
My question for you,
okay,
is how exactly do I subscribe to your live shows? Because I did that. I subscribed to the Snowplow Show YouTube channel, and yep, I never get notifications on there.
Sucks to be you.
So, yeah. How do I do that? So,
I don't know.
Yeah.
I have no idea.
I
know there's a way to do it because somebody made a video of them doing it, because apparently it's not really obvious on YouTube. So there is a way to do it. You just go somewhere and you check a box or whatever. And if someone tells me where to find that video or someone tells me instructions, if you want to just leave a voicemail or an email even or something, I don't know, so that I can tell you guys how to do it, because I have a lot of people asking how to catch the live shows. And I never know how to answer them as far as YouTube goes. What I tell everyone is that they should use Twitter to do this, to catch the live shows. Because I know with Twitter you can pick certain people that you follow on Twitter and make it so only their tweets will get sent to you via a text message or an email or whatever. So I would suggest Twitter, because I'm not always going to use YouTube to do live shows. I have plans to do other things for live shows that don't involve YouTube. So I wouldn't get too comfortable with YouTube, you guys. Some days I might just not want to be on video, and I'll just do the audio only. I'll do the shoutcast thing, which is kind of why I made that page, phonelosers.org/live, for live shows. So do that. Figure it out on Twitter. I know it's much more obvious on Twitter than it is on YouTube.
Hey, Brad, it's the rock star. Hey, in the latest episode, Permanent Applications, you were asking about whether or not you should add emails to the show, and I personally say just do it. Like, I'm quoting Shia LaBeouf here. Just do it.
All right. I'm going to do it.
As long as it doesn't interfere with the show at all, I mean, if people are complaining, they're just complaining to complain. And I think a lot of us at this point just like listening to your voice. So,
oh,
let's just do it.
Oh, you. How embarrassing.
I was going to say more things, but I just cut this part out. Pretend I just hung up. All right, bye.
Oh, you guys, he hung up. He hung up. That's what happened. That's why that voicemail cut off so abruptly. He hung up right after he said that thing about my voice. Alright, I'm sick of voicemails, so I'm gonna stop doing voicemails, even though I have about 20 of them left. But that's okay, because I'm only 5 days behind on the voicemails. So everything's fine. I'm keeping up with the voicemails this time. You know, I think I said about a month ago I was gonna start trying Periscope out for live shows. I know Facebook has their own thing for live shows now, so maybe I'll try Facebook and just broadcast video through Facebook, just to see how it goes. And there's always Twitch. I have a Twitch account. I could broadcast on Twitch. I think I should just confuse the hell out of everyone and just broadcast randomly on different things every single live show. I'll start paying for my own Mixlr again and just broadcast on Mixlr every once in a while. I'm gonna make things as confusing as I possibly can for you guys. So be prepared for that, even though I'll probably never get around to any of that. I'll probably just keep doing YouTube forever. So that's the end of the show. I think we all owe Default Cecil a debt of gratitude for making today's show possible. I never would have been able to be an asshole to teachers if it wasn't for Default Cecil. And holy shit, who deserves it more than those fucking teachers? You know, everybody hates teachers. So thank you, Default Cecil, for making this possible. I will hopefully be doing at least one more show this week, because I've only done one at this point and I really need to do another one. So hopefully this weekend I'll get another show out just to keep you guys happy. We're ending today's show with a song by Nick Vivid. This is from his brand new album. It's called Watch It Fly, and this track is called Roberta. And the reason I'm playing this track is because it's about phones and it mentions Prank Call Nation. I can see Nick Vivid wanted to be topical and do something that was a current thing and not completely gone. So he mentioned Prank Call Nation, because Prank Call Nation will always exist and it will always be a thing. So why wouldn't he mention this in a song? I haven't listened to the rest of the album yet, but it looks kind of cool. There's like another track called Doxed. And I've been getting doxed pretty much constantly for the past 20 years, so that sounds interesting to me. So everyone should go check that out at nickvivid.bandcamp.com, and I will link to that in the show notes.